Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to discuss breast cancer, a condition that affects men and women. Please note that this video is not about diagnosing breast cancer, but to create awareness of the disease. Most breast cancer occur in women, but men carry a higher mortality than women do, primarily because consciousness among men is less and they are most times not likely to assume a lump could lead to breast cancer, therefore a delay in seeking for treatment. I hope this video will change that narrative and reduce the mortality rate associated with breast cancer in men. The breast is made up of fatty tissue and specialized tissue that produces milk. The milk-producing part of the breast is organized into sections called lobes. Within each lobe are smaller structures called lobules, where milk is produced. The milk travels through a network of tiny tubes called lactiferous ducts. The ducts connect and come together into larger ducts, which eventually empties in the nipple. The dark area of skin around surrounding the nipple is called the areola. The male breast structure is nearly identical to the female breast, except that the male breast tissues lack the specialized lobules, since there is no need for milk production by males. Breast tissue is sensitive to changing hormone levels during the menstrual cycle, pregnancy, breastfeeding, weight loss or gain, and breast infection or injury. At menopause, the breast involutes because of reduction in estrogen and progesterone. It also regresses after pregnancy, childbirth, and lactation. A breast injury can occur as a result of a fall, bumping into something hard, or being elbowed. This causes damage to breast with an outcome of bruises, pain, tenderness, and lump. Breast cancer is diagnosed in men over the age of 50 and is usually detected as a hard lump underneath or above the nipple and areola. The disease is more common in older women and occurs when abnormal cells in the breast begin to divide and grow in an uncontrolled way, eventually forming a growth or tumor. Breast cancer can develop in the ducts that carry milk to the nipple, the lobules that produce milk, or the tissues in between. In many cases, the symptoms of breast cancer may go unnoticed until it becomes severe. Moreover, some of the symptoms experienced with the condition could also be observed in benign situations. Such symptoms include a change in the size, shape, or feel of the breast. However, changes in hormones during menstrual cycle could create changes in the breast with possible tenderness just before the period. Breast pain could be symptomatic for the disease, but it is also linked to period, early pregnancy, and side effects of some medications. Scaling, peeling, or flaking skin over the breast, particularly the dark area around the nipple, are symptoms to watch. Although bacterial and fungal infections could produce the same symptoms. A lump or thickening in the breast or armpit that feels different from the surrounding tissue could be a symptom of the disease. However, an injury to the breast causes fat to form lumps that are generally round, firm, hard, and painless. Changes in hormones during menstrual cycle can create changes in the breast with possible lump in both breasts. Pulled in or changes in the position of the nipple could be a symptom of breast cancer. However, nipple retraction can also occur slowly and gradually with age, as commonly experienced during perimenopause. Skin changes in the breast, such as wrinkling, could be symptomatic for breast cancer. Although breast abscess, trauma, and side effects due to some medication could also express these symptoms. Dripping or nipple discharge has many possible causes, including breast cancer. Other factors like breastfeeding, pregnancy, breast infection, and side effects of a medication, including contraceptive pill, could also cause nipple discharge. Skin changes, such as redness or roughness of the breast skin, resembling the skin of orange, is symptomatic of breast cancer. The breast could become red as well if there is a skin infection. The cause of breast cancer is not known, but there are risk factors that could contribute to the development of the condition. Women who are overweight after menopause have a higher risk of breast cancer than women who are not overweight. Men also have an increased risk of breast cancer if they are overweight or obese. Drinking alcohol increases the risk of breast cancer in women. The contraceptive pill has an increased risk of breast cancer. Taking hormone replacement therapy, HRT, increases the risk of breast cancer. Being inactive or lack of physical activity could increase the risk of breast cancer. Some people have inherited faulty genes that increases the risk of developing breast cancer. Genetic testing is available for some of these faulty genes. Having one or more of the following risk factor does not mean that a female will get breast cancer. Many people who have these symptoms or these factors never get these diseases, and some people with no risk factor develop breast cancer. It is critical to see a medical professional with any of these symptoms. Diagnosing breast cancer involve different procedures. Breast screening aims to detect breast cancers early, and the screening protocol uses an X-ray test called mammogram that can spot cancers when they are too small to be seen or felt. The earlier the condition is found, the better the chances of surviving the disease. Physical examination of the breast, checking for lumps, hardness, or tenderness is also a diagnostic process. A sample of breast tissue or biopsy could be taken and examined under a microscope. Based on the biopsy result, further confirmatory tests such as mammogram, MRI, PET scan, and gene testing could be carried out. Heredity plays a role, as people with family history of breast cancer are at risk of the disease. Women who inherited BRCA1 or BRCA2 gene mutations are at an increased risk of being afflicted with breast cancer. Genetic testing for these genes identify these mutated genes, thereby giving men and women the options to implement preventive measures such as single or double mastectomy to decrease the risk of suffering from breast cancer. Treatment of breast cancer depends on so many factors, including stage and grade of the cancer. Breast cancer stage is usually expressed on a scale of 0 to 4, with stage 0 describing non-invasive cancers and stage 4 describing invasive cancer that has spread outside the breast to other parts of the body. There are various treatment options for breast cancer. Breast self-examination should be part of our routine healthcare activity. Benign breast lumps are often found in both breasts and usually have smooth edges and can be moved slightly when pushed against them. If you notice any breast changes, please do not panic, but see your doctor right away to get it checked. I hope it has been informative for men as we intend to reduce the mortality rate from breast cancer in this population. Thanks for watching, and please like and share this video to your friends and family, and I will see you soon.